What's up, everyone? Welcome to the second video talking about musculature when it comes to double unders. Today is kind of a special one because, yes, it does apply to double unders, but strengthening these two muscles are really going to help just your overall movement. Okay? Today's focus is going to be on the lower core, specifically the psoas major, which is part of the hip flexors, and the lower part of the abs. These two muscle groups are the connecting points for our upper body and lower body. So that way, if we have strong muscles there, we are better able to transfer force from our legs to our upper body and vice versa, even though it mostly goes from the legs to upper body. But anyways, if those areas are strong, we have better force transmission, right? Think about jumping rope or double unders, it's force transmission around. Alright, so let's get to it. First exercise, psoas raises. Okay. If you've done my pull-ups program before, then you're familiar with these. If not, no worries. Basically, if you're new to it, don't have the mobility that you've seen others have, you can start with your hands behind you. And what we're going to do is, for a minute, on each leg, just lift it as high as we can, right? We don't want our chest up like this. We want it nice and compact. Think about a hollow bowl. You're gonna feel a burn, like a straight line through your core right here, right? So a minute each leg, boom, a minute, boom, a minute. If this is too easy, you can reach your hands forward, which shortens that range of motion, making that muscle work harder. So I'm able to lift my leg not as high. Right? If you want to make it more difficult, you can lift that leg over the hip. But moral of the story, keeping your core engaged, punched over our hips, and lifting each leg or bottom of them. Right? This could be an exercise that you need to do on a daily basis for Metcon. It's just great for our overall movement. Most importantly, when it comes to double unders, it's important for force transmission from our feet to our upper body. So that's the psoas group. Right? Psoas raises, solid movement. Next up, I have a sandbag behind me, right here. I'm going to rest my upper body against it and get myself into a hollow body position. Okay. This is the reason why I'm resting on the sandbag, so that most of the focus can be on my lower. Hips extended,